Hello, welcome to the Dugout Show. Here is where the magic happens. I sit there, Matthew sits over there. No one can top that magic. See you in the episode. Welcome back to another episode. So, we have a special guest today. It's Healy. So, Matt, what about those Patriots in the combine?
Well, there's not really much to talk about. I mean, we can say the draft is coming up. But who do you think is going into the draft for the Patriots?
Well, since the Patriots have the last pick, who do you think is, like, going to be, like, the last draft prospect, pretty much?
I don't know.
So, pretty much of the combine, let's talk about Chris Johnson, man.
Yeah, he was a beast.
Bro, he set the world record for fastest player.
He just had an astonishing performance there. He did well in every thing he did.
Yeah, and who was that, like, lineman who set the world record for fattest player to run?
I don't remember.
Me neither. So, Healy, do you know anything about this?
Gonna be completely honest, I don't do football, I do hockey, so I have no idea what you're talking about.
Good, because we have nothing about hockey. So, Matt, who do you think is, like, the next prospect to come out? Like, a good player, sort of.
Well, first off, this was very surprising that... Did you see Kyler Murray attend the combine?
I'm sorry. Did you just say that right? Kyle Murray. Murray, I don't care. Attended the combine.
He didn't.
Oh, he didn't? He's like the fastest quarterback I've ever seen.
He's like a quarterback and a running back. So he's like... Holy goodness.
Yeah,
he's
don't forget.
Really good. It just depends what team he has. Because whoever needs him
gets him.
Yeah. They only get the people they need in the draft.
Yeah, so like we said, let's name the teams that don't have a quarterback. The Dolphins, the Baltimore Ravens.
The Jaguars,
the Jets. Raiders. What?
The Raiders.
Well, Raiders are cool with Derek Carr. But anyway, five teams that come get them. There were bad teams this year.
Yep.
So, Matt, you know what that means. True or false? Matt, what's the question of football? So anyway, while he figures it out, let's talk about those Patriots.
First of all, I don't have one.
Anyway, think of one. How do you think of the, like, okay, since he's figuring out a question. So, the Patriots, man, you're getting the last pick, but I think they're still going to do good. Actually, we have another special guest, Ralph. Hi, Ralph.
Ralph doesn't have a mic.
That's true, but, hey.
Over in the corner, if you can hear me.
Yeah, it's fine.
I have an opinion on the Patriots. I think... They're gonna, like be screwed for, like, a season or something without Gronk. But then they're gonna, like, rebound and find, like, another guy who's, like, good. And then Tom Brady's gonna retire, and then we're screwed after him.
And then
we're just screwed. Permanently screwed.
They released Dwayne Allen on Monday.
Wait, what?
Yeah, so now we have, like, no tight ends if Gronk retires. We're gonna need someone. In the draft, I believe that, Noah Fant, he's from Iowa. I believe he will be our new tight end.
Yeah, but what, like, draft prospect or number is he supposed to go?
I don't know. He had a really good time at the combine. He did pretty well on it. He, whew, man, I think he, if he goes on the team, he'll do well.
All right, that's good. So, Matt, have you figured out that question?
Sorry, man, I don't have one for this one.
Well, think of one.
No, just move on to the next
one. I'll move on. So, what's next? It's the Boston Celtics with a historical moment this season. You know what that is, Matt.
Yay.
Yay. They won by 32 points. Woo!
Against the Golden State Warriors. Are you nuts?
Mind
blown. I didn't watch the game. I just hear this from them.
Yeah, I hear it. Definitely. So, the record, well, before that, have you seen their record, like, before the All-Star break, before, like, that win?
Yeah.
They started off 0-4.
That was absolutely terrible. I totally expected more from them.
What? 0-4? When this, you have Gordon Hayward coming off the bench? This team should be number one. No, they should be number one by 10 games. Are you nuts?
I think you're the one going nuts. And
I think I am. Anyway, Healy, have any thoughts on this?
No.
Well, that assumes why.
Like I said, I'm more hockey. That's the only sport I play.
I can see on your shirt.
Like, in this group of sports you're talking about, I only know hockey, so, sorry.
Well, I can see on your shirt.
Yep.
So, well, I think they're going to be like the Patriots. Like what Healy said, when you don't have Brady and Gronk, you're screwed. And when you don't have Kyrie or Jason Tatum, you're screwed.
True.
Just like that.
Anyway, hey, Ralph, any thoughts on this? Anyway, Matt, you know what that is. True or false? Did you write one down this time?
Yes.
Good!
It's not really a true or false question. So it's kind of like an A, B, C question. So it says, how many assists did Larry Bird get about per game? Is it A, 5, B, 6, or C7?
Well, knowing Larry Bird and his team, it wouldn't be like that low of a number for 5. 6 or 7, I can tell he can be sharing the ball more because you have Robert Parrish back then and Kevin McHale. Then yet, you still had like good players. So I think the answer is B, 6.
You are correct.
Yay!
You win the prize of nothing, because we don't have a prize.
Well, sorry, Healy, but Bruins are last in our list. No, second to last.
Darn it.
Anyway, so, the Red Sox. In free agency, what will they do? Is the main question.
I'm not sure if they can acquire some good players. Let's just hope they don't drop any players.
Well, let's ask Nick. So, Matt, let's get Nick.
Okay.
Because, so, like, we have so many, like, players getting acquired because of, well, we're losing a bunch of players because on their last year of their contracts.
Yeah, it's just going to be really sad.
Nick knows nothing about Red Sox.
Yet, the first episode, he knew everything.
It's a mystery we shall never solve.
Anyway, so, well, they got rid of, major contracts that they didn't need. Like Rick Porcello's contract and Drew Pomerantz. So, they can re-sign, like, players on their last contract, like Xander Bogaerts or Jackie Bradley Jr.
We cannot lose those key players.
I do know that Bogaerts is really good, so we need to keep him.
He's a good shortstop, we lose Jackie. That is, oh my God, that is huge.
Bogaerts is good at hitting, right? He's like the good hitter.
Yes, he's a good hitter. Anyway,
I played softball for 3 years. That's all I know.
So is Mookie. And wait, Tyler, do you have a Mookie shirt?
Oh, wait, I was thinking about Mookie Betts. Whatever.
Bruh. But Jackie...
I have serious skills.
Well, Jackie, in the like the postseason, went off for hitting. But during the regular season, he didn't like do much hitting, but fielding was his key.
It's true.
I'm just going to go along with that. That is now true.
Xander Bogaerts, he was a good fielder. He's been known for hitting. His fielding is just normal plays because he's so old. He's won, like, what, three championships or something like that?
I think so.
I don't know. So, Matt, you know what time it is.
Okay, it's true or false time.
What's the question?
True or false? J.D. Martinez had 121 RBIs.
Well, I believe so, because he hits, like, what, 40 home runs? Oh, wait, before that answer. Hey, Ralph, any comments on that Red Sox?
No, I haven't been watching the Red Sox.
He
all.
Says no.
Ralph still doesn't have a mic.
I realize that. Actually, thank you.
He actually answered it. He said no.
Yes. Thank you. So, the true or false question, I'm going to go, no, he had more.
You're correct.
Yay!
Good job.
He actually had 130 RBIs. So, I'm just picking a random number.
Anyway, so, Healy, it's your time. Will you introduce the segment?
Sure. It's time for hockey. Yay.
Yay.
Hold on. I'll be back, but I'll be in the studio.
So, what do you think of those additions?
A lot. For example, they won in overtime. Good job. So, nothing else really to say, because I don't really know much about them.
Yeah, of like their new forwards of Johansson.
Hello. Hockey's great.
I realize that.
Yes.
Thank you.
Johansson has been playing pretty good, but not that much. But he's been playing good.
Yeah, but don't forget, he has to share the puck with, like, so many good players.
True. He does have... What? No. He does have some high bars set for him. So, feedback. Okay. Oh, my gosh. Okay. Anyway... Matthew, I think you need to fix the audio.
I'll be right back.
He got stuck on the microphone wire. Anyone who's actually watching,
sorry.
Hope you enjoy. Anyway. I stole your seat, because I know this. Hello there.
Hello. What am I?
Nothing. Our microphone's on. Is our microphone on?
Yeah.
Cool. Okay. Regarding the Bruins game last night, that was a beautiful, beautiful overtime goal. Beautiful play. The takeaway goes around the net. He's covered, and then he, like, sees that he has help in front, makes a beautiful pass, beautiful move in front, right around the goal, easy tapping goal. Beautiful goal. Great job, Bruins. What do you think, Matt? Do you still not know anything about hockey?
Yeah. I mean, that play, I believe that play was pretty good.
It was definitely competition because it was a 3-3 tie, so wasn't a really predictable game.
I saw a little bit of it, but not much.
All right, it's true or false time.
Okay, here's the question.
Really good.
Okay.
True or false? Zdeno Chara has 4 goals this whole entire season.
Wait, like he has or he
has this entire season?
Like he has every single game?
No. Just like his career. Not his career. This year. This year in the season.
Of course he scored goals. True.
So it's true?
Yeah. I think so.
That is correct.
Yeah.
It's either four or five. I never finished.
So anyone that thinks defensemen can't score, that's not true. Our defensemen can. So their defensemen might not be able to.
All right. Do you follow the Bedford Bucks?
My brother's on their team. We lost in the playoffs. Also, fun fact about the Bedford Bucks, everyone on the team got mullets for the playoffs, and then we lost two games in, and it was very funny.
Well, the fourth grade travel team made it to the semifinals, and now they're playing Weston.
We have a fourth grade travel team?
Yes, we do.
I'm talking about the high schoolers.
I know. The girl high schoolers also made it. The hockey season's also for the Bedford Bucks coming around the corner.
Nice. Anyone follow basketball? Oh, wait. I know we had a basketball game recently. I think on Wednesday. Wednesday.
We follow. The girls were doing well.
But I think they still won.
But they're still...
I think the girls won.
The girls won?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
That's a good bet. I mean, our basketball team isn't doing too bad, so that's a pretty good bet to put on the team. All right,
Healy, you want
to
end it off?
Sure. Thank you guys for watching The Dugout. This is where the magic happens. I got that from your intro. Thank you for watching The Dugout. Thank you, Matt and Tyler, for letting me host your hockey show part segment.
You're welcome.
So, yeah, thanks for watching. Join us next week. I don't know when.
Next week, right after the next class.
Next week at 3 o'clock on Wednesday. And if you don't have time to join us then, we're live on YouTube, live on Bedford TV. Also, it's on YouTube after we shoot it live. So check it out there. And, yeah, enjoy.
See ya.
Bye. Thanks for watching.
Time.